you will realize that the spread between the different outcomes, like the price between the different outcomes, is very big, which essentially means anyone who wants to trade has to pay the spread, which essentially translates to a fee for the user to actually participate. So this is something that makes it really costly for users to participate, but also the way how currently market mechanisms work are also very gas costly for those that actually want to do professional market making to operate on those, which is the main reasons why professional market makers don't even consider to participate on markets like Augur. Another issue is also that if you want to be professional, like a professional trader on any of those markets, you have to understand those markets, and you have to build a model for those markets, basically a trading strategy. And that's difficult because most markets are quite unique. You have to spend a lot of time to think about those markets, and it's just not worth the effort. So here's where Omen comes in. So Omen is a fully decentralized prediction market. It is using the Gnosis conditional tokens framework. There's another talk about this at some point here at the conference. It is using another type of market mechanism, which is an automated market maker. Yeah, something like Uniswap that most of you know is used here to allow traders to trade on those markets. And as an Oracle mechanism, we use a combination of Reality.io the Reality.io platform together with the DXDAO. I'll explain this in a second. It's important for you to know this is not a Gnosis product. This has been developed by a different company called Protofire. It has been funded by us, but it has been developed by another company, and it's actually not operated by Gnosis. It's operated by the DXDAO. For those of you who don't know what the DXDAO is, the DXDAO was created last year to create a DAO that allows to govern decentralized infrastructure, something like Omen. And it's an organization with about 400 members that will start governing this protocol. So there are a few building blocks that are required to make Omen work. One is the conditional tokens framework. And the conditional tokens framework is basically allows you to use the elemental mechanism to create prediction markets. So to give you an example, if you would like to create a market, will Donald Trump be reelected as president in 2020? Then the conditional tokens framework allows you to register this event. And then any user can convert collateral, in this case you could say DAI, into outcome tokens. In this case, a yes token and a no token. And then the user who wants to trade, he keeps the token that he believes will represent the factual outcome. So in this case, user would believe, yes, I think Donald Trump will be reelected. So he keeps the yes token, and he will sell the no token on the market. Now, this could be any market. And then let's say Donald Trump will be reelected, then the Oracle will report to the conditional tokens contract, yes, Donald Trump was reelected. And now the user can use this yes token, go to the conditional tokens contract, and redeem the DAI for the yes token. And the no token that the user was selling on the market is actually the profit that the user made. So now this is the simplest possible way to use the conditional tokens framework. You can do much more with it, like really crazy stuff. Actually presented this last year at ECC, so I recommend to check out our new dev portal, where you find all information about the conditional tokens framework. However, for Omen, we really just need this very simple mechanism that I just explained. So next question is, and that's where Omen makes a difference, is the market mechanism. So I was mentioning we're using an automated market maker. We call it the fixed product market maker. And the fixed product market maker is very simple, and I think pretty much all of you know and probably have used this market maker before, because it is a market maker which is used also for Uniswap. Yeah, it follows this very simple formula where you have the supply of the two tokens which should be traded on the market maker, and this should always multiply to the same constant. And if you want to sell one for the other, then basically you are shifting here on this curve the amount of tokens that you want to get in return. And the great thing about Uniswap is it's very simple, like it's a good user experience, the user can instantly trade, and there is always liquidity available. So now, for Omen, this concept had to be twisted a little bit. So if you think about Uniswap, you always trade one ERC20 token for another ERC20 token. In a prediction market, this would be basically limiting the prediction market to binary events. But in prediction markets, there could be many more outcomes than just two. Let's say we want to predict who will be the next president, then we would have, of course, many candidates. Or if you would like to predict who is going to win the World Cup, we need the possibility to have more than two. And so fortunately, it's very simple to extend the Uniswap formula. And that's what we did. So you can basically just add tokens to the formula and can basically allow to trade an arbitrary amount of tokens within the same market maker. It's a concept that's also being used by Balancer Finance. And this is basically only limited by the amount of gas that you can use. And we tested it. It works with about 32 outcomes. So another small change that we did to Uniswap is how liquidity is incentivized. So if you think about Uniswap, anyone is able to contribute liquidity to the Uniswap market maker. And there is a spread, a small spread, of 0.3%, which basically translates to a fee for the user. And this fee is accumulated in the Uniswap market maker itself and just added to the liquidity pool. Now, if you think about the market maker in the context of a prediction market, what you essentially trade on this market maker are outcome tokens. And the specific thing about outcome tokens is that as soon as the event occurs, the outcome tokens, which are not representing the factual outcome, they lose all value. What this essentially means is that as soon as an event is resolved, anyone has the possibility to just buy all the winning outcome tokens from the market maker, and the market maker will end up with all the losing outcome tokens. This is also a risk that is inherent to all Uniswap liquidity providers. I think most people are not even aware. But if you add liquidity to Uniswap pool and one of the tokens is losing all value, then the liquidity provider will lose everything, the ether and the tokens that they provided. Same thing here. Just in the case of prediction markets, it is very clear that at a certain time, most tokens will have no value and the market maker will lose basically all its funding. So it's quite a risk for the market maker to participate here. And that's why we changed the way how fees are taken and accumulated to not decide to just add them to the liquidity, because this would mean at the end the market maker would have still nothing if he doesn't decide to withdraw liquidity at some point. But instead, it's collected separately. So in case someone adds liquidity and people are trading, then the trading fee is collected in a separate balance, and as soon as the user wants to withdraw the liquidity, they get their share from the fees that were collected over this period of time. The fee is quite high, it's 4%, but this is still very competitive if you compare to other prediction markets, no matter if they are on Ethereum or if they are actually with fiat money. This is a very competitive rate and allows basically liquidity providers to be break even if 25 times of their liquidity contribution is created as trading volume. So those are basically the main differences to Uniswap, how this can be applied for prediction markets. Next question is, how can we actually resolve those markets? So there are quite a few oracles available. Of course, for Omen, we want to have a fully decentralized system. The oracle should be fully decentralized. And there are also decentralized oracles available. Augur is definitely one of them. There are also others. But the problem with those oracles is that they are very slow and very costly. And it's actually a bad user experience for users to wait forever until the market is being resolved. And I think Vail, one of the projects building on Augur, they decided actually to offer the user to pay them out even before the Oracle is being resolved, if something is quite obvious how it's going to be resolved, just to offer a better user experience. But that's not really how it should be. So we were looking into solutions how to improve this. And one solution to this is the Reality Platform. And what the Reality Platform essentially does, it's kind of a filter which allows anyone to ask questions and have a very simple mechanism to resolve them. And only in case a result is contentious, then you can trigger final arbitration, which allows to call a more complex mechanism to resolve the market. There are three very simple steps. First one is just asking a question to Reality.io. So you have to post a clear, unambiguous question in English. You have to define a resolution date. And you can also set an incentive for someone to actually post the correct answer. In case of the prediction market question, it's not really needed, because you can assume people participate in the prediction market, and they just have an incentive to resolve those markets. And then lastly, you have to also select a possible final arbitrator for this question. And in case of Omen, this is the DXDAO. So now, if a question has been asked and the resolution date has passed, then anyone is able to answer the question. And you do so by posting the answer together with the bond. The bond can be maybe like 0.1 ETH. And then assuming that no one will post another answer to kind of overwrite your answer, then the market is just resolved. You get your bond back, plus the reward, if there's any. But in case someone is kind of challenging your answer, what he has to do is he just post another answer, but he has to double the bond. So he has to post 0.2 Ether, and then so on and so on and so on. And the risk that you have is, as someone posting an answer, is that in case you're wrong, or the final arbitrator will decide that your answer is not the correct answer, you will lose everything. So this system has shown to be quite efficient. So every question that has been asked on the Reality Platform so far has been resolved actually without triggering the arbitrator. This might be also the case because right now there was not a lot of money involved, and of course I hope Omen will change that. But so far, the system has proven to work quite fine. And so, basically anyone who participates here in this process, they make the bet that the final arbitrator will decide in their favor. And if so, then they actually earn a profit based on the bonds that have been placed on basically losing bonds on the other answers, plus eventually an incentive fee. And again, like, Reality.io doesn't really solve in that sense the getting the truth on the blockchain, but at least it allows an efficient mechanism to filter out all the questions that can be simply answered. And only in case people can really not agree on what the outcome is, then it allows to anyone to trigger the final arbitration and make sure that a more complex mechanism can resolve the question. And that's where the DXDAO comes in, because the DXDAO will be the arbitrator for those that are challenged on Reality. So the DXDAO, again, was a project that was started last year with the goal to govern decentralized infrastructure. And it's something based on the DAO stack framework. Over 400 addresses participated. And initially, the responsibility of the DXDAO was to govern the Dutch exchange protocol. But now, I think we see there's more and more requests coming for also other protocols to govern interfaces and protocols. One of those is Omen. And now, how can an arbitration be done? It basically follows the same process as any DAO stack proposal to the DXDAO. So anyone can make a proposal for arbitration, and then the one making or submitting this proposal has to basically pay the DXDAO for for arbitration, so there's a fee. And that's actually something that the DXDAO still has to decide on. What is a reasonable fee to ask for? And this should be a pretty high fee, because you want to ensure that, first of all, not every prediction market is escalated to the DXDAO, but also the process will actually involve quite a few people to participate in the DXDAO, so this should also be taken into account. And yeah, we think probably something above $1,000 will be a reasonable amount for arbitration. This can then also become a nice revenue stream for the DXDAO. And yeah, I think this could, assuming that, yeah, many people post many questions and there will be more money involved, then I could see that this happens quite often. Yeah, so there's some more additional features that we built into this product, or that were built into this product. One is just simple, like, additions to make it a more social experience. So we integrated with three-box comments, which allow anyone to comment on prediction markets. And actually, you can also associate your own Ethereum account if you want to, and could even associate your Twitter account. So you can really put your money where your Twitter account is, so to say, and signal how you think things will play out. The Omen is also using something that we call the contract proxy kit. It's a proxy kit that we developed in Gnosis to allow better user experience. I will show you a demo in a second, and you will see what it can actually do for you. Essentially, one of the big benefits it can bring to dApps is that it can batch transactions together. So instead of the user having to confirm all the time transactions, now they can be bundled into one, and you can actually create a prediction market in just one transaction. So you can create the RealityIO question, you can register the question in the conditional tokens contract, you can create the market maker and fund the market maker, everything together in just one transaction. And we're also integrating with the Kleros token TCR, so prediction markets on Omen can be funded with any type of ERC20 token that is registered via this TCR, and yeah, allows a nice user experience. All the important tokens, all the stable coins, all the legit tokens have been added there and allow users to easily select those. So now I will try to show you a demo, and I'll try a live demo. If it doesn't work, then I guess I can show you video. And yeah, I will show you how to create a prediction market in 60 seconds, hopefully. So one question, what could we ask? This is just on Rinkeby. Please only use it on Rinkeby so far. We could ask something about ProcPow, if ProcPow will be running on Ethereum mainnet until end of 2020. That's something that I guess is interesting for the Ethereum community right now. Yeah, okay, then you have to pick a resolution date, which would be, of course, end 2020. And then here, right now, DXDAO is still missing, because the DXDAO has actively accept to become an arbitrator, and that's still... So yeah, here you see DXDAO is still missing as an arbitrator option. This is simply because the DXDAO has to first accept that they become an arbitrator, and they have to, again, decide on what the arbitration fee is. So for now, I will just choose the reality team, and then I can select the token, the collateral token, in which the market will be funded, and I can decide on the funding that I contribute to the fixed product market maker. And in this case, I will add 10 DAI. And now I have here two outcomes. In this case, it can just stay like this, and then, that's already it. I can click on create, and hopefully I don't have to log in. No. And yeah, now the prediction market is created. So this entails creating the question on reality.io, creating the conditional tokens, creating the fixed product market maker, and fund the fixed product market maker with a DAI. And okay, yeah. I hope it worked. It should show up in the markets overview then. And it doesn't. It's unfortunate. Well, okay, you can check later, maybe it's just the internet. I'll just, so yeah, basically the creation process is really, you just thought, basically you can create a new prediction market within 1 minute, fund it, and then anyone can start trading on it. And yeah, the next step I wanted to show you, so usually this should come up, like you successfully created a prediction market, is to trade on those markets. And as you see right now, the initial distribution was 50-50. And now I just select the outcome that I believe is the correct outcome. And I select the amount of DAI I want to invest. And as you see, by investing some DAI, you can already see how the outcomes, how the probability of the outcomes change. And if my prediction is confirming what the interface shows me, then I can buy into this prediction market. And that's it. You can, that's all you have to do. So it's a very simple process, as simple as exchanging tokens on Uniswap. And I think that's what makes this model so attractive, is just the simplicity for creating prediction markets, but also, of course, trading on them. It's also showing how to fund those markets, so how to add liquidity is equally trivial. You just select the market you want to fund, and then just add DAI or remove DAI. So I hope many of you will start playing around with this and create markets on whatever you're interested in. It's also a great way to actually retrieve information. So if I would like to know where next DEFCON will take place, I could just create a market here, ask where next DEFCON will take place, and send the link to to the Ethereum Foundation members, and eventually someone will participate in this market and send out a clear signal where it will actually take place. Not sure if there's any time for any. Okay, all right. Then yeah, if you have questions, just come see me after. Thank you very much.